Advise officers, nataka uniseme mkisikia, we have advised them that they should cooperate even much more closely for the purposes of making your work easy. Your work as a RC, as DMC, is to make sure that there is order, isn't it? You want people to fish in an orderly manner and they don't break the law, isn't it? Anything else? Senior, mzee wa kicha kila mtu kama ndio kwenda kuvua samaki na vuliwa inavuliwa kwa njia ambayo iko kwa mujibu ya sheria. Sheria ya Kenya na sheria ya Uganda. That's what you agree. And our principal mission for coming here was to just underscore and restate the already very good relations between the people of our two countries. Uhusiano ni mzuri. Hatutaki watu waharibu. Hatutaki mtu mkora haribu. Hatutaki to create space ambayo wakora wanaingilia na kufanya mabaya mabaya. Hapana, hatutaki. Sababu itaharibu uchumi wa Migingo na itaharibu uchumi ya sehemu hii ya Afrika Mashariki. That's the principal reason why we have taken time to come here. Nothing more than that. So kama kuna mkora, mwambie hapana Migingo, tafuta mahali pengine, hapana hapa. And I'm very happy. In fact, you are just confirming what they have said. Over the last number of months, hapa hakukuwa na matatizo. Even when we arrived with the IGP, he said, this place looks very cool. It's not like when I was here last time. Yes.
Calm?
Yes.
Siku hizo?
So that's it. We thank the officers, we thank you for doing a good job. That we are not only charged with the responsibility of law enforcement, the care. He's mentioned something very, very fundamental and extremely important. That one of our key responsibilities is assisting the people of the public. You cannot say, umekuwa mgonjwa, hiyo si kazi ya polisi. Hapana, hiyo si kazi ya polisi. No, hiyo ni kazi ya polisi. So we need to use the resources that we have.
Joint.
Kusaidia wananchi wetu. So we came to see how when the advice we gave them is being implemented. But we insisted that the law must be observed by everyone who wants to be part of it. Because you cannot have a different way than that. So, you can't.
Could the deficit paving way or a roadmap towards mitigating some of the challenges for our fishermen have been facing?
Oh yes. The very reason that you are seeing both of us here is a testament, I must say, to our commitment to ensuring that any frictions that may occur are handled at bilateral level. I mean jointly. We deal with them jointly. That's why I invited him. And you can go to the island for yourself and ask them. Ask them to pronounce them. You can go there and find out for yourself.
Is your colleague is
about the matter you're doing. But I will only speak about the alleged assault. An assault, whether it is against a police officer or a civilian, becomes automatically a police case. So that officer is free to report to the nearest police station for action. Whichever side.
But the general impression you got was that they're working very close.
They're working very close. They're working very well.
So there is no problem in Migingo?
We didn't see any problems. The issues that were raised by a few residents, which, to my understanding, is people want to go and fish overseas, and they don't want to observe the law overseas. What happens? You of course face assumptions as the law of that land requires. So if you want to fish, please follow the law. Even at a hut, that's not part of the Sharia. Kama watu wanafanya tu fishing bila wanataka. There are certain rules you must follow.
Just to emphasize on the point that the IG has mentioned, that the enforcement is not selective. It's against whoever is fishing, of whichever, whether they are Ghanaians, whether they are Kenyans, or they are foreigners from other countries. As long as you follow the law, there is no problem. But once you violate, like for example, fishing without a license, using immature nets, or committing crime. The criminal is not a law nationality. So that's so there's nothing targeting Kenyans. And actually, this is my third visit to Migingo. I'm impressed with what so I was telling you, right, that Migingo has improved. It's now a town, and there's no more tension there. The past encounter, rowdy crowds, raising, but there's harmony. And even the leaders.
Yeah, exactly.
The beach management.
So kindly tell us the Uganda's commitment to mitigating this outcry that are surrounding the Migingo issue.
Well, this is why we...
That's why we are here.
That's why we went there. We were looking for that outcry.
We didn't see it.
I think it's more in the media than on the ground.
At any rate,
the most important thing is there is a mechanism which we agree on how we could call the management team until the survey is complete. Which survey is not really...
So in a way, the media is blowing things out of proportion.
Absolutely.
Maybe.
That's the impression we got.
Yes, that's the impression we got.
And again, you see.